printing, power supply, and eConf access. In this video, we'll cover how to connect the power supply to ePowerControl, mount the controller, and access Elum's configuration platform, eConf. This video is divided into 5 sections. Required materials: wiring the power supply, mounting Elum's device, configuring the LAN port, accessing the configuration platform, eConf. Part 1. Required materials: Elum's device, data logger or controller, and a power supply that can deliver the following: flathead screwdriver, electrical wires, black for negative, yellow, green for ground, red for positive. Laptop: RJ45 to RJ45 Ethernet cable, USB to RJ45 adapter if your laptop lacks a LAN port. Crimping tool: wire strip, boot lace ferrules, AUPS, optional. Part 2. Wiring the power supply. For the power supply, start by connecting the AC mains to the connector. Then, connect the phase wire to the phase terminal, L. Connect the neutral wire to the neutral terminal, N. Connect the ground wire to the ground terminal. Connect the load to terminals 1 to 2, paying attention to the polarity. Now that the power supply is properly connected, we will proceed with connecting Elum's device to the terminal blocks. On the terminal blocks, connect the power supply wires for the Elum's device, red for positive, black for negative. Remove the power terminal block connector for easier cable wiring, keeping in mind that the shielded ground, protected ground contact is the top pin of the 3-pin power terminal block connector. Using boot lace ferrules is recommended here. Connect the positive cable, red, to the V positive pin. Connect the negative cable, black, to the V negative pin. Connect the ground cable, yellow, green, to the ground contact. Ensure all cables are securely connected to the power terminal block connector. Reconnect the power terminal block connector to Elum's device, keeping the ground contact at the top. Use a screwdriver to tighten the screws at the ends of the power terminal block connector. Ensure that the connector is securely connected and properly tightened. Part 3. Mounting Elum's device. The ePowerControl should be mounted on a DIN rail. To do this, pull out the bottom slider, secure the unit onto the DIN rail, and then push the slider back in. Shake the unit slightly to check the locking action. Power up Elum's device. All the LEDs will blink as an indicator that power is being supplied. After 60 seconds, the operating system will be ready, and the power LED will turn solid green. Check that the power LED of the central computing unit is on. Part 4. Configuring the LAN port. eConf is the Elum configuration tool. It can be accessed locally without an internet connection, as well as remotely through our monitoring platform, ePowerMonitor, EPM. Connect your laptop to the LAN port 2 of Elum's device. Access the settings from your laptop. Go to Network and Internet Settings. Go to Change Adapter Settings. Right-click on Connection to the Local Network. Select Properties. Click on Internet Protocol Version 4, TCP/IPv4. Select Properties. Select Obtain an IP address automatically to enable automatic IP address allocation, or select Use the following IP address for manual IP address assignment and enter the settings as shown in the next window. Click on Yes. A small TCP/IP window will appear. Click on OK to save configuration. Part 5. Accessing the configuration platform, eConf. Open your preferred browser and log in to eConf by entering the following IP address: 192.168.4.127. The following window should appear. You can now begin configuring the device. If you need further information, please feel free to contact Elum's support or your sales managers. Eager to see you in our next training session.